Good morning, guys. Dwayne Lazar, Triple Nickel Trapper. April 27th, I want to show you something here. You guys saw that dam was draining the other day? Well, look at these rocks here out in the water. They were just barely sticking out the other day. I'm thinking we lost a lot of water here. We'll get in here and have a check, though. Some elk poop. Wow, that trap was right on the water's edge, and look at it now. We'll be pulling these today. I'm pretty sure that we've caught everything in here, so. Depending how deep it is in there, maybe another family will move in before the fall. It's too bad that dam drained, but the farmers would have just come out and did it anyway, so. Well, that one's coming out of there. Look at this, you guys. They just can't resist these sticks when I lay them out for them. So much water disappeared, there's not even a place to drown themselves anymore. Wow, we were set way back up here before. Looks like we're gonna get one today, I guess. I'll dispatch and pull these traps. Hopefully there's still a couple more here to fix that dam. This is a fairly good sized one. Well, that was a damn heavy trip with the beaver. I figured out why he wasn't so feisty and wanted to fight. Ouch, right by my casters. Poor bastard, I feel for him now. Well, we got this set up, guys. We got a couple on the house and a few conner bears on trails. We're gonna go set that pond with that 100 pounder in it. Don't really want to catch him, but I mean, if I do, I do. I'm not sure if I'm going to do it today or not. It's pretty windy out. I don't think this phone picks up the wind as much as that camera does. And right now my GoPro's saying the card's busy. So I don't know what the hell that means. So I think it means I need a new card. What the heck? Well, you look what that bugger did. Move the dam back. Now I can't walk out there. There's a cross right through that stick halfway across, or that tree halfway across, that there's a slide up top to bottom. And man, I've come out here so many times, double, one on top, one on the bottom. But that's the old man's house there. I figured I'd come out and maybe see if I could get a shot at him with the camera here, but nah, that's just a little too slippery for me to be carrying a 100-pound beaver back across. I mean, I've been across that dam many times, but they've always ran up here. And it was like, you know, this, yeah, I'm not so sure. I'm gonna have a smoke and make up my mind. Maybe I will. I'm just down from that dam over that we were just stopped at. They got a leaker here too. This is a new dam. I've never seen this before. Coming out right here. I'll let them fix that up and maybe I'll get in here and set some. I see they're gnawing on trees and stuff, so they've got a few of them down over there. Well, that's good. I like seeing the beaver make a comeback. We haven't had any out here for a few years. I might be partially to blame for that. But they're definitely here. Nice. Well, I'm just coming back from a beer run. I thought there was snow all over the road, but it was geese. Look at the geese out here. I'm gonna try to keep it steady, but forgive me for not keeping it steady. I don't like to exaggerate, but there is about 27 billion out here. Oops, that was my, wow. I'm in my car, so I mean, that's my door jams and stuff when it goes black, but there are tons of them out here. So many. Look at that. Unbelievable. Well, we're back at this new pond. Pretty dead over there, man. I don't know what's going on here, but we've got a couple here. This one on the trail. And nobody there. Excuse me. Then I set the one up over here, because they have a definitely coming out of the water there. Looks like it might have been fired. You betcha. There we go. Not a very big one, but a beaver nonetheless. All right. I don't know what's happening at that house over there. I'm just not getting any breaks, I guess. It could be pretty trap shy here too, because I've trapped them here years gone by. So I put a little bit of caster on that the house over there, so maybe that'll bring them in tonight. We're gonna go set another new pond again today. I will reset this one. Wow, we got lucky there. Look at that. That bugger didn't fire. All right, we'll grab the setters and away we go. Well, buggers are in here eating a lot of trees. See where they're coming out of the water here? Hope you can see that. There's a couple of Bridger 5s in there, chained off to a tree. Now, we'll go get some 330s and put some 330s in on some of these other exits from the water. That wouldn't be too bad of one, except it drops off awful deep and I don't want to make it any different than they're used to, so. But yeah, they knock trees down everywhere in here. There's a dam right there and another one right here. They fixed this one that was all buggered up the other day. But yeah, we got a nice little in and out right there. And another one just up ahead here. So we're gonna put three conibers in. Hopefully we can grab a couple of beaver next time we're here. There's another one there. But yeah, they got their little dam fixed again here. And I noticed there's another dam down there, but must be a few beavers here to run that many dams. I don't know how many, but all right, Hard goes up there. We'll go get some more gear. All right, we got one in there too. Pretty well-worn trail up here. Excuse me. Oh, be tough carrying beaver out of here. You guys think it's funny that I can drive right up to my traps, but there's only two that I can drive right up to, so one in there. I did not set the dam. It looks pretty mucky. I don't want to try walking across it because I think I'd sink right in up to my giggy. But there's another run up there. And we got a conibear in there too. So from there, they're coming up here. And as you can see, they are knocking down the poplars. Oh well, let's see what happens tomorrow. I'm not sure what we got out now. I think like a dozen traps or so. All right. Well, there's a pretty big bugger. Bridger 5 sitting on the house. Decided not to drown himself. That's the one I told you yesterday. I put some caster out for him. Obviously that worked. So we're gonna get over there and dispatch him and reset. I guess I might as well shut this off. We're gonna be a bit. That's, well, I guess that's not our first trap of the day. I stopped at Carla and Matt's place and there's nothing there, but yeah, I'll get taken care of this guy. He's a nice big one. Back leg catch. I see the other bridger behind him there. It's in the center of the screen behind that twig now. But yeah, we'll take care of him and we'll have a look at him. Oh, he didn't want to give up. He wanted to bite. Tried to bite me a few times, but that number 5 bridger setter takes the bite right out of him, man. He's a big one. Okay, well, I'm going to go check the other ones while I'm here and let him bleed out a bit. A big beaver, man. He got all screwed up here. That's the only thing that saved me from getting bit. Yeah, he's a big, big gold brute. Nice, I like the big ones. Yeah, I can leave those bridger setters there. Well, it's a little surprising, but we got nothing here. Huh. I really thought those leg holds would have one in it, but it is a little cool today. We'll give it a day for the scent to wear off. They will be coming through these spots. Oh. Man, that wind coming into the west just about knocks my hat off. Had to hold it on a couple of times. Oh well, it has been a week since I got a video out to you, so nothing here. So we will try and upload this one for you when I get home. It's been taking like 12 to 14 hours to upload a damn video, which is ridiculous. But it is what it is. Might be Saturday morning video for you guys, I don't know. Anyhow, we'll get home. Couple beaver to skin. Well, you guys, till next time. Keep moving forward. Well, out in the shop, I got some bear bait hanging for Christopher Bochak, my little brother. It's looking really good, buddy. It's going to be just about how you want it when you pick it up. I wanted to show you that fairly big beaver. He's a pretty good size. That board he's laying on is over 4 feet wide, and as you can see, he's hanging off this side of it. So he's a fairly good sized beaver. That's her 3-year-old on the other side of them there. Yeah, I got guys calling, they want some bait, so I better find some beaver. There is pretty scarce out in this country right now, so. Oh well, we'll keep looking.